Hey guys, my name is Ozzy and today I'm gonna show you guys how you guys can create this vector design road using Inkscape. I'm gonna show you guys how you guys can create the road and the strip using the stroke style in Inkscape. So it's gonna be a simple trick, so let's get into it. Alright, here we are in Inkscape. So first thing first, let's create a line using this bezier tool. And I'm just gonna left clicking here, holding control and drag it to the right. And left clicking it and press enter to finalize it. And I'm just gonna change the width into 200 pixels. There you go. And I'm just gonna create a perfect circle. Hold control plus shift and drag out to create a perfect circle like that. And make sure you turn on the lock to turn on the proportions. And let's change the width and height into 100 pixels like that, and turn on the snap smooth nodes and just snap it at the edge of this line. Alright, and now we want to duplicate this line. Select that, control plus D to duplicate, and just snap it down here at the bottom of this circle. And we duplicate this circle, press control plus D once again, and just snap it right there. And we just duplicate this line and just snap it on the bottom of this circle again. And lastly, we duplicate this circle and just snap it at the line. And right now, let's duplicate this line and then change the width into 100 pixels. And snap it at the bottom, and we duplicate this circle and change the width and height into 50 pixels and just snap it down here. And we duplicate this line again, control plus D, and just rotate it 90 degrees on the clockwise with this button over here, and you'll end up with something like this. And let's just hold control and roll up the mouse wheel to zoom in. And we're just gonna create a line again, but this time across the circle like that. And we duplicate this like that and snap it here. And just duplicate this again and snap it here. And we duplicate this lastly and change the height into 50 pixels. So it's matches with the height of our circle down here. Alright, and now we left clicking it and drag it to select both of the vertical line and the circle, and go to the path, cut path. And what the line do with cut path feature is that it's gonna delete the circle into two pieces like that. You know, this one and this one. And with this one selected, I'm just gonna press delete to delete that. And we do the same thing with this circle, go to the path, cut path. I'm just gonna delete this inside one. Just delete that. And lastly, with this smaller circle, go to the path, cut path. And just delete this right side. And apparently, I need to delete the bottom one as well. So let's just do that. Hold control and drag it to the right. And select them both. Go to the path, cut path. And just delete the bottom one. And you'll end up with the shape of our road like this, as you guys can see. So let's press control plus A to select everything. And just go to the nodes tool. And as you can see, there is a node over here. But there is two nodes actually. So you can see on this status, 2 of 23 nodes selected. And because they are stacked each other, they are not really connected. So it's just like 2 objects together. They are just stacked each other. So we need to unify them together. So let's just select them both, as you can see, and select these join selected nodes to join them. And if you drag them around, they're actually become one node. So that's what you want. This one, join selected nodes. With this one again, join selected nodes, and so on. All right, we are done. As you can see, if we deselect it and select it again, it's become one object. So that's what we want. And right now, the root is just too thin. So let's change the width and the width of the stroke into something like 40 pixels. Like that, yeah, 40 pixels is good. And we press Ctrl plus D to duplicate that and hold Shift and click on the white color palette and change the width of the stroke into something like 2 pixels to create the strip like this on the road. And right now, let's change the dashes into something like gapping, you know, something like this. Maybe even gap. Alright, there you go. I think this line is perfect. And I don't really like how this unconnected strip. So on the dashes, on the right side of the dashes drop down, as you can see, there is an offset column. So let's press the plus button to offset that. Maybe like something like 5 pixels, I think is good offset. And if you take a look at the bottom one, yeah, it's pretty good. And now let's select on the white outline, go to the path, stroke to path to finalize that. So it's become a path, so you cannot change it, the width of the stroke. And right now let's select the black outline like that. You'll see it in here, status bar, the stroke is black. And go to the path, stroke to path to become a path. You know, we can change it around like that. And right now the road color is black. I don't really like it. Maybe just dark gray is good. Yeah, something like that, because asphalt is not that dark. It's dark, but it's not black. So let's press Ctrl plus A to select everything. And let's press Ctrl plus G to group everything. And yes, our vector road design is complete. So that's it, guys. That's how you guys can create vector flat design road using Inkscape. And let me know what tutorial or what kind of videos you want in the future. And as always, thank you for your time.